Hey guys and girls, this is Arish from GainMediaLab.com. Welcome to my exciting world of live audio mixing. Today I talk about a habit that you might have developed that can seriously affect your work as an audio engineer. If you want to know how I deal with it, stick around until the end of the video. But first, if you're new to this channel, please subscribe and get notified about all new videos. I try posting them every Monday. With that out of the way, let's go. Saturday, March 7th. The date of my last gig before everything was shut down. I remember joking with the band and other crew members that we should say our goodbyes as we were leaving because we might not see each other again for a long time. Now the joke is on me. I really miss it, you know. The adrenaline rush of a live show, the people, the adventure. Being away from it made me realize how much I really love what I do. But this long period of not doing live sound brings another bitter realization. We are living in a world of bad, bad sound quality. Now, I imagine I'm not alone in spending a big chunk of my time trying to become better at what I do. Oh, that reminds me, you can still get the discounted tickets for the Live Sound Summit 2020 event by following the link in the description below. 20% off for 5 days of the biggest names in live sound, explaining and sharing all of their knowledge. Be there. So I'm spending my time glued to my computer, watching webinars, doing online calls, attending Zoom conferences and other online meetings that have been promoted, and I've realized a frightening concept. All of the time, the audio quality in these sessions is severely degraded. Like, bad. Like, really, really bad. I mean, it's not surprising if you think about it. Most of this content has been recorded through Bluetooth microphones, integrated computer mics or headsets of, let's say, questionable quality, then squashed by the online conferencing software that is only concerned with getting some kind of an AV signal through. I always have the image of server rooms with network cables that are getting so hot with all this traffic that they actually start glowing in the dark. Yeah, I know, I'm weird. I'm working on it. On the other side, there we are, ingesting it all through computers, phones, and iPads, or put on Bluetooth headphones because it's convenient, right? It's comfortable. Wireless is great. We spend a huge amount of our waking hours listening to content that is just slightly better than a garbled speck of a waveform. And our listening skills are put to work just trying to make out the words, not the details of the sound quality. And then online calls and phone conversations with our friends and family, where we get more of the same. And then we spend our downtime watching Netflix, which has reduced its streaming quality. We can't really influence how all this content is produced. We have no way, or desire for that matter, to tell the people who are making this content, hey, could you please be a doll, run out, get a better microphone, dampen your echoey room a bit, and then lecture on this amazingly important audio concept? Of course not. We're just thankful that they do it. But what we can do is influence the way we listen to content on our end. We have the power of putting on a great pair of our reference headphones instead of using some wireless Bluetooth model that reduces the sound quality even more. We can use monitors in our small studios and not the tiniest computer or phone speakers that cut off any remaining low end that manage to make it through. I'm seriously worried that our listening abilities might get severely impacted. Just consider how much time we have spent training our ears and our brains on how a good vocal should sound. How much effort it took us to hear how compression was used on audio material. Think also about how we did that. We trained our ears and our minds by repeating and memorizing panning positions, frequencies, and dynamic processing settings. We played games on Sound Gym and tried to get the perfect score that would tell us, hey, great job, your ears are getting golden. Here's the big question. are you willing to find out how long it takes you to untrain your ears and just have them tuned to this much worse version of sound? I'm not saying in any way that you should not learn new things about our craft. I'm also not suggesting that you do not talk to your friends and family members. You know, that's what makes all of this bearable. So here's my solution. Stop listening to content through computer speakers and AirPods just because it's convenient. Your reference headphones can only become your reference headphones if you use them constantly and compare audio material through them. Be active about training your listening skills. Take an hour a day, put on your reference headphones or go to your studio monitoring system and do some critical listening exercises as well. Hit Sound Gym, get that score up. When you watch YouTube or Netflix, use your reference headphones and play the listening game. What is the fundamental frequency of that presenter's voice? How long is the reverb tail of the room he is standing in? How much compression can you detect in the audio material? Trust me, no one cares as much about audio as people that are trying to make a living in the audio industry. We should fight for it tooth and nail. And we should fight for our ability to do our jobs well once this whole thing is over. Soon, I hope, for all of our sakes. Let me know in the comments below how you train your ears and keep your listening skills in top shape. This is it for this episode. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to check out GameMediaLab.com for more delicious content. Stay safe, take care, and mix great shows. Bye.